गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेसन नंबर 6 थर्मोडायनामिक्स 11th क्लास। नाउ थर्मोडायनामिक्स लास्ट टॉपिक पार्ट 8। आई टॉट यू अप टू इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी कंप्लीटेड अप टू दिस हेसिस लॉ ऑफ कांस्टेंट हीट समेशन। ओके, नाउ 6.5 इज ओमिटेड एंड 6.6 इज ऑल्सो ओमिटेड एंड वी आर स्टार्टिंग विथ अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज 6.7 गिब्स एनर्जी चेंज एंड इक्विलिब्रियम। ओके, बट टू अंडरस्टैंड गिब्स फ्री एनर्जी चेंज एंड इक्विलिब्रियम अर्लियर विच आर ओमिटेड आई एम टीचिंग यू सम फ्यू पॉइंट्स Here I taught you there is no connection with the Gibbs free energy enthalpies for different types of reactions. Okay, so this one is omitted. Okay, but here after enthalpy the word spontaneity will come and the word entropy and spontaneity will come. Okay, so in short I am teaching you what is entropy. So this is so much detailed in theory, you can go through this. Okay, but I am teaching you some terms for the entropy which will come in Gibbs free energy. See, entropy is denoted by delta S. Delta S formula is Q reversible upon T, that is equation 6.18. then what is entropy? Total is entropy of system plus entropy of surrounding. Okay, this is greater than zero. This equation is 6.19. okay, so what is entropy? When a system is in equilibrium the entropy is maximum and the change in entropy is delta S is equal to zero. We can say that the word I am teaching you entropy and spontaneous, we can say that entropy for a spontaneous process increases. Entropy increases till reaches maximum and at equilibrium the change in entropy is zero. Okay, at equilibrium means with one example I am teaching you. See, calcium carbonate, if we are giving heat it will convert into CaO plus CO2, but the reversible reaction if is carried out, okay, so again the formation of calcium carbonate. When the equilibrium will come, okay, at that time the entropy will zero. So again you can see of only system, not of total, that is called Q of system reversible in reversible reaction upon temperature. Okay, so we find both that reversible and irreversible. See, irreversible and reversible. Reversible means coming back, irreversible means only product reactant turns into product. Here product, reactant goes to product, product comes to reactant. Now we find that both the reversible and irreversible expansion for an ideal gas under isothermal condition delta U is equal to zero, but delta S total, that is systems and surrounding, is not zero for irreversible, it is greater than zero. Thus delta U does not discriminate between reversible and irreversible process, whereas delta S does. Okay, so this was the formal, just informal knowledge about the entropy. Now I am giving some introduction for the Gibbs energy and spontaneous. I taught you the entropies and spontaneity relation. Now I am giving a relation between Gibbs energy and spontaneous. Now what is Gibbs energy? Okay, see, earlier in entropy I taught you delta S total, surrounding and system. Okay, Now, relation between Gibbs energy and spontaneity. Okay, now we have seen that for a system, it is the total entropy change which decides the spontaneity of the process. But most of the chemical reactions fall into the category of either closed systems or open systems. Therefore, for most of the chemical reactions, there are changes in both enthalpy and entropy. Enthalpy means H and entropy means S. Okay. It is clear from the discussion in previous section that neither decrease in enthalpy nor increase of entropy alone can determine the direction of a spontaneous change for the system. To understand this, we have to follow this a new thermodynamic relation that is called the Gibbs free energy. Now, what is Gibbs free energy? G is having relation with this enthalpy H minus at the temperature TS. This is 6.20. Okay, entropy and enthalpy is relation. Now, the change, if we will follow delta G system is equal to delta H system minus T delta S system. Okay, I taught you know here for the system only. So, at constant temperature, delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. Okay, so delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. This equation is 6.21. This is the introduction of Gibbs free energy. Now, thus Gibbs energy change is equal to enthalpy change minus temperature minus entropy change and is refers to the Gibbs equation. This is called the Gibbs equation, one of the most important equation in chemistry. Okay, here we have to consider both terms together for spontaneity. Now the relation, again I will show delta G is equal to entropy change. See, delta S surrounding is equal to delta H upon temperature is equal to surroundings and systems. Then S total is equal to system plus and this minus. So, rearranging the above term, you are getting T delta S. T will come here. T delta S is equal to T delta S minus H. Okay, so T delta is minus T delta H greater than 0. This equation, so Gibbs free energy is more than 0. Delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S less than 0. This is 6.22. So this will come in MCQ or it is omitted. Delta G gives a criteria for spontaneity at constant pressure and temperature. If delta G is negative, if delta G is less than 0, is negative, the process is spontaneous. Okay. If delta G is positive, more than 0, the process is non-spontaneous. Okay. Now, our last topic I am teaching you, that is 6.7, Gibbs energy change and equilibrium. Now, we have seen a knowledge of the sign and magnitude of a free energy change of a chemical reactions allows first prediction of the spontaneously of the chemical reaction. I showed you here if it is negative or if it is positive. If negative, the spontaneity prediction of useful work that should be expected from it. So in short, so far we have to consider free energy change in reversible reactions. Let us now examine the free energy change in reversible reaction. Reversible. Okay. So this and this. See, for reversible, under strict thermodynamic sense, in a special way of carrying out a process such that system is in all times in perfect equilibrium with its surroundings. When applied to a chemical reaction, the term reversible indicates that a given reaction can proceed in either direction, okay, forward or reverse. This is called forward reaction. Reactant converts into product, forward, and reversible means product turns into reactant. Okay, this means in both the terms, in both the directions. So for the criteria, we can say, I'm driving you one, for the first reaction, A plus B, reversible reaction, I'm teaching you. C plus D, reversible. Okay, so here Gibbs free energy is zero for the reaction. Gibbs energy for a reaction in which all reactants and products are in a standard state, delta Gibbs free energy is related to the equilibrium constant of the reaction as follows. Okay, so this is 0, delta G plus RT, natural log K, PV is equal to NRT, you are knowing, no? So delta G RG, if we are keeping here, and this comes to this side, minus RT, natural log K. So natural log we are converting into log, delta RG is equal to convert natural log, we have to add 2.303 RT and log K. You are knowing, no? Natural log is converting into log, so you have to add this number. This equation is called 6.23. Now we also know that another reaction I taught you earlier, delta G R reaction, is delta R H in terms of entropy and enthalpy we derived earlier. So we are keeping still delta G and delta G. So this and this equations are same, is equal to, we can say, minus 2.303 RT log K, or we can say RT natural log K. This equation is called 6.24. So we derived in two terms. Okay, now for strongly exothermic reactions, where the heat is liberated, exothermic reactions, the value of delta RH may be large and positive. Okay, the value is large and positive. In such case, value of K will be smaller than 1 and the reaction is unlikely to form much product. Okay, so reactants are going to convert into product and product in this case. In case I am taking about positive means endothermic. Okay, in endothermic the value will be positive or large. So reactants means we are supplying the heat. So reactants are going to convert into product. Okay, one side. Second, this I taught you first. Second, if the reaction is exothermic, the products are going to convert into reactant, means reaction will be to this side. Okay, so using equation 6.24, this we can say it is possible to obtain the estimate of Gibbs free energy from the measurement of delta H and delta S. If we are knowing entropy and enthalpy, we can measure the Gibbs free energy and then calculate K at the temperature for economic yields of products. If K is measured directly in the laboratory, value of delta G at any other temperature can be calculated using 6.24. Okay, so students, I completed my lesson and you can do on this Gibbs free energy which I taught you, these different derivatives, delta G. Okay, delta G is equal to, again I am repeating, minus RT natural log K ln K, then delta RG, natural log is going to convert, so minus 2.303 RT log K, and in terms of entropy and enthalpy, I taught you delta H reactant minus T delta S in entropy relation, T delta S. Is equal to, that is minus RT natural ln K. So finding these relations, you can calculate the problem number 6.12, 6.13 and 6.14. Okay students, I hope you well will, by putting only the formula, you can do these calculations. Okay, students? Okay, so I am completing my lesson.